Hey guys, Kiko here. I finally gonna do a Q&A video. A lot of requests, a lot of questions. So probably gonna do every week or every month, I don't know. So let me know. So leave your questions and let me know if it's better to do a Q&A video every week or every month. You will find some Q&A videos on this channel, but I was never doing like consistently. So now that's the idea. So I got the first questions from Instagram, actually. So let's do it. Suvarna Ibanez, or Suvarna Ibanez. Good name, by the way. You look so confident and energetic while performing on stage. How can we be like you? Oh, thank you, Suvarna Ibanez. But first of all, don't try to be like me. I don't think it's a good idea. Just be you, you know, get inspired by different people, by different artists, you know, but just be you. Collect all these influences and mix them up and just play, do music, do art, using, you know, being yourself. But to be confident and energetic, so let's talk about confidence. It's, for me, it's all related to practice. I differentiate the playing, the performance, and the practicing. It's all start when you practice. So you go there, you need to play the entire concert. So you're gonna play like 15, 20 songs. So you have to go to every detail of all those riffs and solos and really practice every little thing and be sure that you know how to play. You memorize the whole thing. And then all the technical difficulties, you just go there and practice and practice. Just be confident. Then after, you have to play the songs. So you just be at home playing the songs and then you get comfortable playing those songs over and over and over. Then you go back to the practice and fix and correct the little mistakes, the difficult parts, the problems that you encounter when you're just playing the songs. Right? Another thing that's very important if you want to be very confident on stage is to stand up and play, you know, walking around your room and having like bigger movements. Because when you're on stage, you have to have, you know, like your arm movements, the way you walk, the way you stand, just like larger movements. And you have to get this timing of having a larger, you know, bigger movement and how you play that. Also, you will learn the timing of when you can do that and or when you have to focus and just stay still and, you know, look to your instrument and be sure that you know how to play that difficult solo, that difficult scale. So you will learn the timing when to be just like freely moving and when you have to stay still and focus on the part. So first you start practicing, fixing all the problems, then you just play, get the flow going, just get the vibe going, and then you practice standing and walking and like having this body movement while you're playing. And then of course the rehearsal with your band or rehearsal with your friends, playing loud and getting comfortable with other distractions and that you might encounter on a stage, right? So this is crucial to feel confident on stage. And then, of course, you can always film yourself, you can watch your videos, you can learn what some other players, how they do. Also, it's very important to get prepared. The warm-up part, you know, half hour, 1 hour before the gig, what are you doing to get ready mentally and physically to go to the stage? About the physical aspect, what I do on tour, I run. I try to run half hour, 45 minutes almost every day. So I get this the energy. So when I go on stage to play a 1 hour, 1 hour and a half concert, it feels good. The running or just walking for an hour, that helps a lot. Going to the gym, these kind of things, you know, it's very important. And of course, you know, playing. The more you play live, the better, the more confident you will be. And there's a lot of people that I know that don't feel comfortable playing live, and that's okay. That's okay. You might be a great studio musician. You can be a great YouTuber playing in front of a camera and can, you know, do music for other artists, for games or whatever. So there's a lot of possibilities if you're a person that doesn't feel very, you know, you don't feel that the stage is your place, you know. And for me, I love playing live. I love playing in front of a crowd, you know, on stage. It is a sacred place. It's a blessing to be able to travel around so many countries and meet so many people and play live. And that's my element. So thank you for your question. Another one from Jacob Dufour, or Dufour 2002. What drives you to play guitar to this day? Great question. Yeah, playing guitar, playing acoustic guitar, playing keyboards, piano, that's home. You know, feels like home. You know, that's my own mental, you know, is where I can go and find myself. And it's a superpower that all the musicians have. You know, just give an instrument, or not even that, you just imagine music and melodies, and you can go anywhere, and you can feel good, and you can feel peaceful, and that's it. Feel you're in a great place. It feels like home. And then I think it's a great thing that music can give you. So if you don't play any instrument, just go there and try to learn something, because guitar, ukulele, or anything, drums, or just start singing, because it's the best thing you can do for you. All right? I think I answered that, right? Yeah, cool. I believe I will be playing music forever. And yeah, because it's just part of me. But being a professional musician, that's another thing. That's another challenge. And you don't need to be a professional musician to enjoy music, to have this great feeling that I was just trying to describe. All right? So yeah. So just go there and try to learn an instrument and discover that yourself. So this one I need a guitar to answer. From Kyle Norbert. How does thumb position on the back of the neck affect your playing? So, yes, of course, it affects a lot. So if you play like this, you know, that's pretty cool to play pentatonics, you know, but it's hard to open your hand, you know. So to open your hand, you have to put your thumb here, right? So then you're able to, you know, do like wider stretches. Cool. So always when I need to play scales or any solo, any position like this, I will have my thumb down here. And if I'm just doing a bend or a chord, you know, or playing Smoke on the Water or something, then yes, I can put my thumb here. Cool? Great. Another one from 50A Rig Mand Mad Pro. Nice name. So how do you play guitar with your strap solo? All right, so I have two situations. With Megadeth, I do put my guitar kind of here, you know, it's pretty low for me, but I'm able to play the songs like that. And normally I start the tour maybe here, and then slowly I, you know, I put it a bit lower. It looks nicer. If I do a guitar clinic or if I do a concert playing my songs, then I need to have the guitar kind of here, a little bit higher, just because I need the, you know, the just harder songs to play, and then I need to have the guitar here, so I'm more confident to play everything. So basically, I kind of have two different straps positions, one for Megadeth, one for my songs. It's the same for strings, you know. I use 1046 standard tuning for my songs. In Megadeth, we use D standard 1052s. So yeah, the Dario NYXL strings. So also I have two different sets of guitars, two different sets of strings, and also the position of the guitar as well. Now this question I receive all the time. So here we go. Yakiv Lemak, what's your favorite Metallica song? So my favorite Metallica song, Mechanics. That was funny. Come on. Mechanics. But actually, you know, so I like Metallica, of course. And I saw Metallica for the first time live in 89 in Brazil, São Paulo, Brazil. And back then, I was pretty young, you know, 2 years old, of course. No, I was 17? I mean, it was so hard to have any concerts in Brazil back then in 89. So it was cool to see the Injustice for All concert. It was pretty cool. Then I think I've seen them some other times, and I had the chance to play in festivals with them. So yeah, but the favorite song, of course, Mechanics. That's it, our first Q&A. I hope you like it, and send me questions. And don't forget to check the link down below, my Indiegogo campaign for my new solo album, and see you on the next video.